Lipids are substances that dissolve in nonpolar solvents. And water is very polar, so that means that lipids don't dissolve well in water. They're biological substances that are oily or greasy, and fats and oils certainly fall into that category. In the lipid chapter, there are 12 learning objectives, 12 principles that we'd like you to have a good feeling for, and one of those is the reactions of fats and oils. Not necessarily the most important of those 12, I think they're all equally important, but maybe one of the objectives that you'd have the most difficulty with. So let's have a look at it. Here I've got the structure of a typical fat and oil. They're both triesters. You can see this ester linkage right here. It's written in a reverse way from what you might be familiar. Here's the C double bond O, and I've put the O on this side. And there are three of these esters, so we call it a triester. This portion of the molecule comes from glycerol, and so sometimes we call fats and oils triglycerides. And R is our symbol just for the rest of the molecule. Can be anything. We haven't specified what it is. But in this case, with fats and oils, R is usually a long chain fatty acid component. And in the case of fats, this R group is not only long chain, but it has few double bonds in it. That is, it's pretty saturated. In oils, of course, are liquids at room temperature. They have more double bonds, more unsaturation, or less saturation. Saturated means CH2, CH2 kinds of groups, whereas unsaturated implies that there's a double bond present. As you know, fats typically are associated with animal sources, beef fat and pig fat and so forth. Oils are associated with plant origins. When we look at the three reactions of fats and oils, we'll be looking at the reactions of these ester groups in two of those reactions, and in the third, we'll be looking at the reaction of the carbon-carbon double bond. Let's have a look. Here I've listed the three reactions of fats and oils. And I think our mind works in terms of words rather than C's and H's. So it helps a lot to write these reactions down in terms of words, and then we'll look at some actual structures. The first reaction is hydrolysis. That means the reaction with water. Fats and oils can both react with water. It takes an acid catalyst. If we were to do this reaction in the laboratory, it would be a difficult one, because fats and oils, we know, are not soluble in water. That's where the acid comes in. It would help. The body is a lot more efficient. The body uses enzymes. And in the digestive process, when we take fats and oils into our body, lipases catalyze this reaction. And it's tremendously efficient. The products, glycerol, and the three molecules of fatty acids. If we were to use sodium hydroxide rather than acid, it's a process called saponification. And again, fats and oils both undergo a similar kind of reaction. We get glycerol, and because it's under basic conditions, rather than getting the fatty acids, we get the soaps. We get the salts of the fatty acids, and salts of long chain fatty acids are known as soaps. So this is a pretty important commercial reaction that we have. The first is very important as well, because as we take fats and oils into our body and they're broken down, we get a lot of energy from glycerol and fatty acids. So both of these first two are important. The third reaction is called hydrogenation. And I've shown it here just with the oils. Oils typically have a lot more unsaturation or double bonds in them than the fats. They can react with hydrogen. It requires a catalyst, something like nickel. And as these double bonds pick up the hydrogen, they're converted into a saturated product. That is, the double bonds disappear. This too is a commercially important reaction. This is how margarines are made, for example, from vegetable oils. And it turns out that in the cooking process or just using these substances around the home, it's nice to have something to spread on bread. And so you'd like a semi-solid product, and that's where margarines come in. This is sort of a controversial process right now because when this hydrogenation takes place, some double bonds stay within the structure and have a trans relationship. They're called trans fatty acids or trans fats, and those are believed to lead to higher cholesterol production within the body. Let's look at these three reactions now in actual structures. Writing the reactions of fats and oils takes up a lot of space. And so that means that your likelihood of seeing a lot of these on quizzes and exams is pretty slim. More often you'd see these reactions or questions expressed in words. Here's the structure of a typical fat or oil. And I've left these two as simply abbreviated as R. They could be anything, but they'd be long chain. And here I've got a CH2 with parentheses followed by 16. That means there are 16 of these CH2s in a row, a total of 18 carbons right here. And so if we had another 18 and another 18, what would that be? 54 carbons plus 3 is 57. 57 carbons and 3 functional groups, you can see why it would be insoluble in water. But in the hydrolysis, we have an acid catalyst or a lipase. We break these 3 ester linkages, freeing this molecule of glycerol. So here's the structure of glycerol, 3 carbons, an OH on each of those positions. We get 2 molecules of fatty acid. And then where I've indicated one specific structure, it too would be a long chain fatty acid. Stearic acid is a C18 fatty acid. In saponification, we'll use the same starting material. Instead of water, well, water would be around. We just have 3 molecules of sodium hydroxide too. And again, the ester linkages are all broken. So we get a molecule of glycerol. Instead of getting the free fatty acids, we get the sodium salts of the fatty acids. Here's that long chain fatty acid that would make it a good soap. And the third reaction, well, I've changed the structure a little bit. Here in the middle position, I've shown a specific long chain fatty acid that has one carbon-carbon double bond. This is oleic acid. And oleic acid can react with hydrogen. This carbon-carbon double bond is going to pick up the two H's. Nickel's the catalyst. And as this double bond disappears, we'll have 16 CH2s in a row again.